As I said, I got Michael Dwyer with us. Michael, great to have you here.
Good to see you.
Michael and I have been teamed up together, if you will, through a mentoring program out at University of West Florida. Dr. Ed Rinelli in the School of Business, College of Business, has developed a concept to take a student like Michael, who is a master's student, getting an MBA, trying to find a way to team them with someone who's involved actively in the business community, and I guess I qualified for that. Michael, we'll talk about the program a little bit, but I want to let you not brag about yourself because we don't want to seem that way, but talk about yourself a little bit. How'd you get to Pensacola? Why'd you pick UWF? Because unlike Forrest DeMaria, you're not a fourth-generation Pensacolian. You're a fairly newcomer to the Panhandle.
Well, this is true. I'm originally from New Jersey. But how I ended up in Florida was, once I enlisted in the Air Force, I ended up getting stationed at Eglin. And my time in the Air Force was coming to a close after my first enlistment, and I really wanted to get into graduate school. And so I found UWF. And UWF's MBA program is great. It's really approachable. It's also really well respected. And so I applied and I got in and I washed up on the shores here in Pensacola.
Well, this is so good. You're a little bit unusual in the fact that you went through, got your undergraduate for whatever reason. You and I have talked about it, but you stepped right into an Air Force experience, 4 years, United States Air Force, and now you're back into the degree earning world again, getting a master's. I think it speaks volumes though, Michael. That's one thing I wanted you to have you helped me do, is brag about UWF. You could have gone to any school in the country. I know you're a very bright student. You make great grades. You've got 4 years of Air Force under your belt. UWF's got to be lucky to have you, and I think Pensacola's lucky to have a university as capable as UWF to attract a young man like yourself who says, I want to go to the University of West Florida.
Well, UWF is kind of uniquely situated because it's a great school, but it's also a great school in an area where the cost of living is affordable. And so being a student, that's a big piece of it in order to, you know, keep your overhead down while you're getting through. Mm-hmm. And you don't want to graduate with a whole bunch of debt. The other side of it is, like, the faculty at UWF are wonderful. They've been fantastically supportive. And it's really helped push my work to, like, the whole next level. Mm-hmm. And so it's been great. I mean, it was, you have to, any enterprise you get into, there's a little bit of risk and a little bit of uncertainty, but I mean, UWF has paid off in dividends so far. Not to put too much business speak out there.
Well, before we get into the program itself, or your degree itself, nobody likes to brag about Pensacola more than I do, so I hope that you're willing to join the chorus. You're very fond of Northwest Florida as a place to live, much less go to school. I know you've said great things about your experience as just a community citizen here.
Oh, it's been wonderful. I mean, Pensacola is great. It's you've got the beach, but you also have, you got downtown, and so you have a little bit of urban, and then you've got pretty much everything you could ever want. A little bit of highway, and coming from North Jersey, that makes me feel like I'm at home.
just enough interstate that you feel like you're at home, huh?
Yeah, and you got the baseball team and the hockey team too, and so you can always stay busy, and it's always approachable.
You know, it's interesting, Michael. I think a lot of folks would think about UWF and picture X number of students kind of living on campus, going to school. You live downtown. I mean, you're part of economic development. You're in here spending money. You're an outsider coming in, spending money on housing, food, odds and ends at the mall, whatever it is. So you're part of the economic development engine that is UWF for our community. It's great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You like the downtown experience, too, in terms of living downtown.
And I love it.
All the excitement of things that are going on.
Mm-hmm.
It's great. Well, tell us a little bit about the coursework as an MBA student. You overwhelmed with studies or just can handle the workload?
Well, at times it seems like my entire life is centered on, academics at the moment. But the program itself, it's actually a very diverse student population. So whereas I'm concentrating, like I work on campus and, we're doing our mentoring program, there are a lot of people who are working full time. And mm-hmm. So that brings a whole dynamic into the classroom. And so that's been really wonderful. So I've been learning a lot from that. But the coursework itself, like right now I'm taking a strategy class and an ops management class and an economics class. And with business administration, it's a grab bag, but it has a number of very different courses into it, so you can really get a grasp of what's going on in the whole picture of a business.
You find there's enough diversification, I guess, if you will, with the curriculum that you can kind of carve your niche out of that MBA world where you want to go and where do you want to go? What's the ultimate goal for you with your MBA education?
Well, this well, that's what this semester is all about. But what I'm planning on right now is to go to law school after I get my MBA. And it's just, I mean, part of the drive for me to get my MBA was the fact that I was totally naive to the business world. So it was really a wonderful vehicle, if you will, to introduce me to it, to, you know, understand that aspect of America. So
I'm sure the MBA has had a great expansion upon the world as you knew it.
Absolutely.
You're getting exposed to new things, new ideas, new thoughts. Michael, by the way, went to a board meeting with me recently for BRACE, Be Ready Alliance Coordinating Emergencies. So my role in terms of working with Michael, he teaches me more than I teach him, but try to expose him to some of the different things that are going on. May not all be directly related to an MBA, but just what's going on in Pensacola behind the scenes. And I think Dr. Rinelli and the university had a great idea to try to find a way to mentor somebody who's been here doing these things for years like myself with a student like yourself who you just need probably a few doors opened up to see some different things. Do you know other students who are in the mentoring program?
Yes, I know actually a handful, a couple of our other MBAs too. And they're really enjoying it. It is exposing them to a whole different world that they weren't even aware of to a certain degree, you know. And so that's one of the real wonderful facets of this program is the fact that, you know, the students get out there, but the mentors get connected to the campus.
Right.
And so it's kind of like everybody wins.
Yeah, I mean, I meant that sincerely when I said you teach me is probably more than I teach you. There is that reconnection to the university. I've told Michael I taught a couple of courses at UWF in the past, but it's pretty easy to drift away when you work off campus as I do, other than maybe a basketball game or something, two or three times a year kind of pulls me back to the campus itself, but you kind of get pulled away. So if you're out there in the viewing audience and you have a business background and you think you might be interested in working with a male or female student out at UWF in an advanced degree program in business, call out there to Dr. Rinelli's office and volunteer and get yourself. I think right now you'd be on a waiting list because I don't think they've had a hard time finding folks because it is a two-way street. I mean, it really works both ways. The mentor and the student both get a lot out of it. Are there ideas about specifically once you get through law school, what you want to do with that, or is this just another career expansion bigger world understanding kind of 2.5 years for you, or do you know specifically what you want to do with that?
I would like to be a litigator, but it's one of those, it's a lot of it's going to depend on the job market and what's available.
Mm-hmm.
And so we'll have to see, but yeah, you know, that's the next step. Kind of, especially in today's economy, you got to be very, very flexible.
Well, one of the unanticipated connections that Michael and I have, of course, I went through business school, got a degree in accounting. I went on to law school, never used my law degree in terms of a fee generator. I think you use the knowledge all the time. So I think it was a good match. I'm lucky to have been introduced to you. I like the relationship.
I'm the fortunate one.
Well, I like the fact that we share things. There'll be probably a lot more opportunities to do some interesting things as we move forward. So again, proud of UWF, proud of you for being a former member of the United States Air Force. We appreciate your time, your service to our country, as we do all the men and women who serve.